Today's lesson is about fish. What it is and where can we get it? Well, fish can be purchased fresh, salted, smoked, or canned. However, fish lack vitamin C and carbohydrates. Therefore, when fish is served as your main dish, these nutrients must be included to provide a nutritionally well-balanced meal. Hello everyone and welcome. I'm Shay. In the Caribbean, we are quite fortunate in having a large variety of fish in our rivers and seas. Fish is of great importance in the diet as it contains valuable proteins, vitamin D and A. Minerals such as calcium, phosphorus, iron and iodine, and fat and even water. Fish is also important because it can be used instead of meat. The flesh is very tender and is easy to digest. Therefore, it should be suitable for convalescents and young children. It can be eaten at any meal of the day as a main dish or as a snack, and it can be prepared in many different ways.
There are a great many varieties of fish, and at one time, they were profusely available.
However, since the Second World War, there has been a great increase in fishing, and some of the reasons for this is partly to feed humans directly and partly to feed animals reared for food. And this has given rise to much concern about the dwellings of the supplies of some varieties. Some countries have imposed fishing limits along their shores to regulate the number of fish being caught. But the problem still exists. At sea, fish is gutted, cleaned, and frozen on broad special boats before it reaches the shore, as it deteriorates very rapidly once it has been caught.
Fish can be classified into two ways. One is according to its origin, and the other is based on its fat content and type.
One, according to their origin, which are broken down into different categories of freshwater fish like salmon and trout, seawater fish like mackerel, herring, and cod, and two, according to their fat content and type. So we have oily fish, which have more than 5% of fat in their flesh, which is therefore quite dark. And examples of these types of fishes are mackerel, herring, sardines, and salmon. White fish, on the other hand, have less than 5% fat in their flesh, which is therefore basically white. They have oil in their liver, and examples of these type of fishes are halibut, sole, and haddock. Shellfish, which are divided into two categories, which are your small, soft body sea animals, which live inside a hard shell, and examples of these are mussels and winkles. And we also have the soft body jointed sea animals, which are covered by a hard protective crust or external skeleton. And we have our lobsters, our crabs, and shrimp.
Fish has a muscle composition which is similar to meat, but there is far less connective tissue, which means it is easier to tenderize and quicker to cook.
It is important not to overcook fish, as the protein easily becomes tough and the flesh dry. The muscle is formed into flakes which separate on cooking. There is a lot of wastage with fish, example, the bones, head, fins, and often the skin. The only internal organ to be eaten is the roe of some species which contains the egg. Cod and herring roe are often eaten, and the roe of the sturgeon fish, caviar, is a prized and very expensive delicacy.
as fresh fish deteriorates rapidly, it is important to choose it carefully. Fresh fish should have the following.
1. It should have bright eyes, not sunken. 2. Plump, firm skin. 3. Plenty of bright scales firmly attached to the skin. 4. Moist skin. 5. A fresh sea smell. 6. Bright red gills, not sunken. Shellfish is normally sold cooked, as several species are scavenger feeders. That is, they feed from sediments on rocks and pipes, often near sewer outlets. They may harbor food poisoning bacteria that must be eaten as soon as possible after purchase. Fish are sold in various ways. It can either be large fish, like cod, haddock cut into fillets or cutlets, small and medium fish like your herrings, mackerel, trout, which are usually sold whole and can be filleted by removing the backbone, tail, head and fins, and very small fish like your white bait, which can be fried and eaten whole.
For many people, such as Eskimos and Japanese, fish is a major source of protein.
Like meat, the protein is of high biological value and is readily digested and absorbed with little waste. White fish in particular is more easily digested than meat and is a useful food for people with digestive disorders. Unlike meat, the fat in fish consists mostly of oils containing unsaturated fatty acids. The essential fatty acids in oily fish are of benefit to your health.
The following are appropriate ways to store fish.
To begin, fish should be eaten as soon as possible after purchase and should be stored in the coldest part of the refrigerator, but not the ice box. It should be well wrapped to prevent the strong odors from contaminating other foods. It is not advisable to freeze fresh fish bought from a shop, as it must be frozen while fresh. If fish have to be stored for a few hours, it must be washed and cleaned properly and sprinkled with salt and lime or with vinegar. The fish should be covered and placed in the refrigerator as well. If there is no refrigerator, it should be placed in a cool place. If it is to be frozen, it should be washed and wrapped in plastic.
Apart from being frozen, fish can also be preserved by the following.
One way is by curing. Smoking is carried out over wood smoke in carefully controlled conditions. The smoke develops flavors in the fish and has a preservative action. Some fish are cooked and smoked. These types of fish are mackerel. Others are left raw, salted. Some varieties of fish are just salted and dried. Another is canning. Several varieties of oily fish are canned. Example of these, and you see them in your grocery store, are your tuna, sardines, and herring. And it can be served with oil or tomato sauce. The bones are softened and can be eaten, providing a good source of calcium. Keep in mind, fish can also be cooked by different ways, such as boiling, steaming, baking, grilling, frying, and even poaching.
Thank you so very much for watching. We have come to the end of the lesson for today. And do remember, every day you learn, you grow. So keep learning and you'll keep growing. Bye for now.